Well, hello, hello, peeps. Here we have the part 2, the Fury 0 to 1800. We're gonna be discussing some Fury things, and of course, as usual, doing our soul shuffle analysis of the good, the bad, and the ugly. So, first off, even after the buffs, Fury is still in a kind of a tough spot, you know, tough cookie. You're still gonna have times when you're just feeling like you're not doing enough pressure, and Blizzard is, of course, buffing Fury once more. So at least there's hope to look for. The problems with Fury, so these are the things that I kind of wanted to talk design wise. I feel like Slaughterhouse has just been kind of lackluster ever since it's been changed. Unfortunately, it was kind of broken in its normal iteration, but I just feel like they've never kind of were able to kind of figure out exactly how many stacks for exactly how much duration. The more consistent Mortal Strike effects always kind of win against it, right? Sustained damage profile also kind of suffers due to that fact, right? Even though like you're having, let's say, 100% uptime, you still have to get like 3 rampages, right, to get the stacks back up. So if you're not like preparing very good to, you know, get those stacks back up, or you don't have your cooldowns, right? If you're using your cooldowns, you get so much rage regeneration, so it doesn't really matter. So ultimately kind of, I guess something that the class kind of suffers from, just having a kind of very focused sustained damage profile. Here, of course, I'm hitting the DK a little bit more. We can hit the Arcane Mage as well. Like, both targets are good. I think Arcane Mage should be maybe trained just so he doesn't like murder us, but DKs just die to Turbo Cleave, basically just die to physical damage, so there's like not much a DK can do, especially this DK that's not really kiting us. Another problem, right, again, it's just the sustained damage profile, but you can't really get her up damage on Fury, especially in the current build, so stop beating a dead horse here. This is just basically means that like Fury always has this issue right now where if it doesn't do like enough damage, it's just not good in the meta, and hopefully the buffs fix that. Now let's go over a few quick tips to kind of the overall Fury playstyle, the things that I didn't go over in the first part. Defensive techniques, so if you watched my older video you might have heard this, so I'm just gonna go very fast. Defensive techniques, passive defense, very strong, healing constant, impending victory anytime you're low HP. Bloodthirst, again, passive, you're constantly gonna be healing a lot. Main thing to note is that it's all dampening, how would you say, countered or dampening based, right? So you have to make sure, right, that you know and you understand that as the game is progressing, you are actually progressively squishier. So just keep that in mind, right, that your cooldowns as well, your even in regeneration is worth less as the game goes on. So just keep those things in mind. Of course, keep in mind that you're weaker to magic damage than, like, let's say, some other classes, right? You have spell reflect, but that's not, too much compared to, you know, maybe, like, the passive defenses that DH has, etc. But, so these are, like, the things that you should, definitely watch out for. And, of course, using your mobility, intervene back, leap back, and stuff like that to, you know, use to survive in certain situations. I think one game here I survived by just kind of fighting back and we kind of win. Not much to say about offensive techniques, really, with Fury is just try to have as much uptime as you can. Make sure you're always hitting a target. So, you know, if you're getting extremely kited, like there's a situation, I think in the second game, right, I should have honestly probably a few times just kind of hidden and swapped to the DK. Ultimately, this kind of makes me play in a very, very risky right way. Right, like here, a long time ago, like here specifically, I should have been, you know, backed up. Right, and we are actually, we're gonna get the win, but it's like, I should have backed up there way before, and it's just kind of... But, before I let you get on with the video, I do have to inform you that only 4.3% of you are subscribed, so if you have been enjoying the content, please consider smashing that subscribe button. Ends up on luck, right? Try to make most of you out of your CDs, right? Just keep in mind that your damage is, again, just very uptime dependent and stuff. So when you're gonna have a game here where I use my CDs and I get knocked off, that's like extremely bad, and it's just things like that you should just make sure you watch out for. So like when you pop Avatar Recklessness, you have been already kind of CC'd and stuff, maybe you put a few stacks of Slaughterhouse, so just make sure you're doing those things. how we can kind of focus and comment it on the match. Of course, using intervene and all those utilities as a warrior. The main thing that I kind of made a mistake here, that's kind of a constant mistake, is I never once changed my PvP talents. And it would have been extremely helpful to, like, even though having Blood Rage here is really good versus the Mage and the Shaman, healers and the Shaman, Enhancement Shaman as well, so, like, there is reason for me to have Blood Rage almost every single round, but, like, versus the Enhancement Shaman and the DK, I could have had Disarm, you know, and even, like, Battle Trance would have been better, you know, so, like, it just would have something to kind of keep in mind, kind of be diligent about. I also should have taken Shattering Throw versus the Mage, probably, to kind of reduce the effectiveness of the cooldown. Going for the Mage, unfortunately, me and the DK are not coordinating very good here, I must say. To kind of pump the Mage, I've been kind of charging and he's been gripping, and it's just kind of being uncoordinated. I also must say, it's so annoying, this, like, blink back is, like, I swear to God, when the Mage blinks back, I want to cry every time, dude. It's just, I don't know, it just hurts my feelings, man. It's so, this class has so much, like, mobility right now. I'm just pumping the Mage. Again, it's the better target. Hands is quite kind of tanky here. It does kind of good healing now, even though it's, like, dampening based, but it has, like, I feel like overall more defense. I get pumped down, unfortunately. It is what it is. Right, like here as well, I could have maybe looked for to take Disarm, but actually no, like here Blood Rage is decent, here Blood Rage is better, because DK can also slow the hell out of you, right? Yeah, I'm going Mage, but both targets are viable, and I think actually this time we're gonna be killing the DK. But I made sure that the Enhance understands that if we're not able to catch the Mage, we should just be murdering the DK. The DK should not be having a free game behind, you know, just hitting us in the back, right? Yeah, just hitting the Mage. It's easier, of course. Whenever there's a range melee combo, you always want to hit the range, just because you can then kind of stack them up and do cleave damage. So it's kind of a simple... if you know this, of course, if you played before and you played melees, you know this kind of logic. That's why we're still sitting on the Mage, but you should always be hitting something. So in the times that the Mage is untouchable, make sure you're hitting the DK. So, like, here I have charges and stuff, so but, like, I see the Mage is, like, behind the pillar and stuff. I just swap on the DK. DK is in the open. DK takes extreme physical damage. Just unfortunate that the plate class takes extreme physical damage. Again, here, we're just doing so much pressure because the DK is just dying to me and the Shaman. It's not just me, it's the Shaman as well, of course, and just Enhancement Shaman is also just murdering the DK. That's a really good knock. And I think I'm gonna be able to finish out the DK here. Yep. I tell you, I made sure that the Enhancer understands that the DK just dies. Yeah, here again I just say DK because Enhancer is, of course, tank here, we discussed, even though, like, earlier in the round DK has some additional magic tank ability, right? Survivability is just as the game progresses, of course, that's gonna go down quite a bit, and then I'm also doing, like, pure damage to the DK constantly. Here, unfortunately, I have to take a swig of a drink. Some water. Yeah, do a little nice little fear here. Make sure that my Mage is not getting absolutely destroyed. Again, I should have swapped to Disarm, absolutely. Even though they have two Shamans, and getting rooted here would have been painful as hell, right? Just disarming the Enhancement Shaman on the burst and disarming the DK on the burst as well would be a huge, huge damage loss, basically. Or yeah, even might force a trinket. Did I just... Oh my god, I just shrinked it. That's 3-second hex. Okay. It's a little bit... not what you should do. Don't do that. Don't do that. Here I'm back on DK again. Just the easier target. Less mobile. I mean, less mobile. Both enhanced DK. His mobilities suck. It's less tanky, right? And it can't really... It doesn't have an immunity, so you're gonna be hitting it the whole entire time. You see the Shaman, of course, try to do always your CC now, especially since you have two stuns, two ways to stun. You can save your shockwave to AoE stun the melee comp, and then you can just always stun the healer with your Stormbolt. So a good thing to always keep in mind that Stormbolt should be probably reserved for the healer. Here, just pumping. I should have tried to kill the Spirit Link. Get a triple man stun, really good. Yeah, we just have absolute pressure here. The DK, again, I'm just making... Like, I don't understand why the DK is just standing there and taking the damage from the mage when we could have pillared all that damage, so it's kind of, Yeah, I feel like bad to just talk about the other players since we're here to comment it on the Fury gameplay, but yeah, I'm just unfortunate. They could have, I feel like, maybe saved the round a little bit. Because then I would have been forced to go up there and, like, do something stupid, right? Here again, mage as the like the main overall target, especially since it's me in the DK. I think this time we're gonna do a lot better. Again, as soon as you get rooted, just remove the roots. Use my no racial this time, but that's why I say blood rage is still really good. Versus this, like, yeah, double shaman and frost, and not frost mage, but mage in general, just yeah, here having blood rage is very, very good. Make sure I, yeah, I honestly was rethinking there for a second, was that the leap kind of troll, but getting shifting power and kicking shifting power is actually pretty good. So that was actually a pretty decent play. Pretty decent thing to do, right, even though we don't get to catch in there. Okay, now we get the pull going, get the kick, get some bonus damage from the kick, or sorry, from the pummel, but you know what I mean. Can't really go for like cross CC or trying to CC the healer and stuff when we're like separated like this, unfortunately. You almost get knocked during my charge, is it weird? Again, the mage is just taking us for a freaking lap. Because freaking mages are just mobile, it's freaking hell for some reason. Wait to kick because he's been dodging every single... he's been dodging our kicks pretty good. Here we swap, and here we do the smart thing. We just swap on, because we see there's no trinket on the shaman, and we just swap and instantly burst the healer shaman. So that's about it, peeps. I hope you've enjoyed this little video. Like, comment, subscribe, all those things that YouTube wants you to do, and have a nice day.